Hello guys, Shubham here. Happy monsoon to everyone. So today we are going to review the next Android Pie ROM, which is AOS IP. It's basically an updated version to the ROM I reviewed before on my channel. So there's some improvements in this ROM, as I made video on AEX with some improvements. This ROM also has some minor improvements. So let's get into it. So I used this ROM for almost 1 week, that is for 6 to 7 days. The battery of this ROM is quite similar to AEX, but it can only extend up to 2 hours of screen on time on normal usage. Yes, you can use it as a daily driver, but in 1 day you might be need to charge this device for like 3 to 4 times, because it actually needs that much charging. I don't know the battery stats on using for gaming purpose or playing games like PUBG, but yes, as a daily driver you will need to charge your device for 3 to 4 times, which is not that good as compared to AEX, that is USB extended. So in terms of battery life, you will get about 2 hours of screen on time at the max, and about 1 or 1.5 hours of screen on time at the minimum. So that's how battery works on this updated version of AOS IP ROM. So next we move towards the camera. Camera in this ROM works fine as usual. No more things to talk about camera, as it works almost like all other Pie ROMs. Video recording is broken, but camera works fine. As I mentioned in earlier videos also, you will find one video about camera apps which you can use on Moto G4 Plus when you are on Pie ROMs. You can find that video in my playlist of custom ROMs and kernels. So more talking about it, camera works fine. Yes, camera doesn't work fine when it is with auto flash enabled or flash enabled. So never use it, as it will crash and will not work properly. Video recording sometimes work fine when not many tasks are open in the background, and the only task that is camera is open, then video recording works fine, but most of the time it might lag, become slow, or also crash most of the times. So yes, that's all about camera in this ROM. So next is about payment applications. Yes, payment applications in this ROM work fine. As I mentioned in my earlier video, you have to flash the Magisk and zip and root your ROM for this purpose. After rooting it, you can use payment applications without any issues. To get information about how to root using Magisk, you can see my previous video of AOSP extended. After that, payments app like Paytm, Google Pay and everything else works fine. By the way, those guys who don't know the full form of AOS IP, it actually stands for Android Open Source Illusion Project. I don't know the logic behind this, like AOSCP stands for Android Open Source Cipher Project, or I guess Android Open Source Citrus Project something, but in AOS IP it stands for Android Open Source Illusion Project. So next we are moving towards user interface or UI. To be honest, when I posted about the AnTuTu benchmark score in my community tab, the score was hyped and it was so much risen because of the user interface. To be honest, user interface on this ROM is pretty smooth and very smooth as compared to other Pie ROMs. Talking more about it, yes, you will have a lag-free experience in user interface. On enabling the nightlight, obviously it lags as it's issue in all the Pie ROMs, but rather than that, user interface is pretty good and smooth to use. I don't know how, but AnTuTu benchmark was the highest in terms for user interface and user experience. Rather than that, the second was about the CPU and third was about the memory. But the highest score was hiked because of user interface. So this sort of user interface you will get on AOS IP. So let's go to the conclusion of the overall performance of this ROM. So yes, the ROM is comfortable to use as a daily driver. The ROM is pretty smooth and stable. No random crashes, no random reboots or any lags were found if you use it on a daily basis and on normal usage. As I mentioned, you have the only issue with battery life. Battery life drains very fast and you have to charge like 3 to 4 times a day to get stable battery life, as battery life lasts for only 2 hours. Rather than that, everything else in this ROM works fine. I can see some mentionable improvements in this ROM than previous builds, that about user interface which is improved, and as also it is shown in AnTuTu benchmark score. Other than that, it is also pretty smooth and stable. Sometimes in previous AOSIP builds, ROMs used to lag and also reboot sometime when device gets heated too much. This thing I didn't encounter in this ROM, and also camera crashes sometimes in previous builds, but everything they have fixed in this build, so thumbs up for that. And everything else works fine in this ROM without any issues, so you can must put try to this ROM. But on the scale of 10, if you want to compare this ROM with AOSP Extended, then AOSP Extended scores like kind of 8.5 and 9, and this AOSIP scores about 7 to 7.5, and your AOSP Extended wins, and actually it's worth flashing. So then to you, if you want to try, you can try this ROM and see how well it works, and tell me experience in the comment section. And if you face any issues, please comment down below. So that's it for today. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, must hit that like button and subscribe for more such content upcoming. By the way, sorry for the background noise because it's heavy rains in my areas, and because of that so much of background noise is there. But from next time onwards, I will take care of that. So see you guys in the next one. Signing off.